Do. Loading, it's a loading screen, waiting for my computer to catch up with me.
Oh, and don't forget the time he got caught passing a love note to the lizard counselor's wife.
Yeah, I already checked all that. For you to go anymore.
Speaking of
greetings.
Okay.
Greetings.
Yeah, they all basically have the same thing to say as some other guys we've talked to. Okay, well, I'm sure someone's got something interesting. Our home, our livelihood, all sunk in a matter of minutes while we could do naught but look on. Tell me about yourself. Well, we were merchants, what seems like a moment ago, that our ship sunk. We're little more than three men with nothing more to say than boo. What happened here? These bleeding orcs, they can't keep off this place for a life of them. They came in, they're slinging fireballs and swinging swords. Wasn't a thing we could do about it, defend ourselves. About finding work. With our good ship gone, nothing for it. But to get a good, nothing for it but to get a job. Some pickings around here, that's for sure. Maybe you can keep an eye out, though. But that burning ship, it was a right stunning show of magic you pulled, it was. Wish you'd been around when our own barges went down in flames.
Bye. Oh, knowing him.
Greetings.
Straight to the cabin.
Bye.
Right. Oh, these three all the same conversation yet. Bye.
Passing a love note to the lizard counselor's wife.
Is that why we never sailed to Yufulgore anymore?
I mean, don't get me wrong, they definitely have interesting audio in this game. I did not check these.
Sigh seal, shiver me timbers.
Plenty of fish in the sea, but I got the foulest of the lot in my racks.
Greetings. Bye.
I should really pick up another barrel. Ah, it was a water barrel, though.
Well, you see, the gold and silver planets and square aspects
are just awesome. It's another waypoint. Struggle.
What kind of struggle?
The signs are unclear. Tell me, have you felt the coast major interfering with your
flame? Too much to carry?
Yes, I'm sure of it. Tell it to mind its own business.
There's that famous Scorpius temper of yours.
Don't start earning an extra gold piece an hour. Walk out that door.
Good on you. These boss men respect confidence, you know. So what did he say? Well, was it? They labels more suited to my nature, anyhow. Yes, honest pay for an honest day.
Greetings.
Okay, well.
Bye.
Probably not worth talking to anyone who just named Citizen.
Avert your gaze and I'll handle this threat for all our sake.
She couldn't hurt a fly, and I won't let you hurt a horn on her.
One day, Moira, one day you'll show them all.
I'm in it.
No.
If I don't start earning an extra gold piece an hour, I'll walk out that door.
Good on you. These boss men.
So what did he say?
Wow. Sigh, seal, sigh, seal. Shiver me timbers and slither me heels.
Yes, honestly, honestly.
Greetings.
Auritus. Keep a plunger to yourself. What are you doing inside this warehouse, snooping around? About yourself. If it's conversation you're looking for, I recommend a comrade Floris. Or they prefer to call him Loose Lips McGee. So myself, my job is to protect the warehouse. No chit-chat for intruders. You need to have strong opinions about Florius. That idiot man-child would sooner spend an hour chatting up a thief than a minute arresting him. Only hope he gets transferred out of the warehouse and straight to the perimeter. Let him rot off a zombie's ear instead of mine. But even think of him turns into a gabbling hen. Turns everyone into a gabbling hen. Okay.
Bye.
That is a huge package. Okay, I'm assuming the red means pickpocketing. Sergeant Curtis.
Greetings.
Meditation sorcerer, source hunters. When I say sorcerer. I see. I'm Sergeant Curtis, proud protector of this house of Legion goods. Tell me about yourself. Curtis is my name. The Legion is my calling. What is that room exactly? Storing house for Legion supplies. For the most important building in the realm, by my and other others' estimations, and I, Sergeant Curtius, have been trusted to guard it.
Bye.
Glorious. Oh, a source hunter. A very hearty welcome to our humble warehouse. Have a look around, and you don't mind if I pick your brain about a scoop around Andavale. Behind my current affairs. Tell me about yourself. Tell you, this gig sure beats getting my toes bitten off by zombies out in the field. We warehouse guards don't have to do much apart from stroll the perimeter a few times an hour. Of course, every now and again, some friendly folks like yourself wander through here, and nothing beats a pleasant conversation. Though my comrade Horatius was quite different in opinion about that matter. And what's Horatius' opinion exactly? Have you talked to him? Thanks every man, woman, and child who thinks that the police wants to rob it blind. So I so much greet a townsperson with hello instead of a state your purpose. He starts flothing on and about guardly duty and security breaches. You know about the current affairs. As Jakeman says, quite a scandal, no? I myself suspect his wife, Esmeralda, and the butcher seconds that, let me tell you. Again, and he didn't hear this from me, he's going through quite a nasty divorce himself, and there's his children to consider. But I imagine his youngest, Kimberly, won't mind, never did get on well with her mother ever since the incident. Oh, it's unparalleled pleasure having a fresh ear around here. Ratty has just called you Loose Lips McGee. What's that all about? That fuss pot said what? Well, old Loose Lips will let you lowly backbiter know what he thinks about that.
Hey! So, something you'd like to say to my face?
I haven't a thing to say to you. I'm on duty.
Duty?
Put up your fists.
Are you mad? We're guards, not drunks on the street.
Enough! Both of you! What is this barbarism? Back to your post at once!
I started a fight.
Such matters are to be settled on your own time. Understood?
Understood, sir.
Such bickering is all that thieves need to sneak by unnoticed.
It won't happen again, sir.
It better damn well not.
spade, she'll liberate the flesh from our faces.
Come now, enough doom and gloom. Cast your gaze instead upon my fair fanned...
Well, a sorcerer, about time the council took us seriously. Maybe you can start with those two idiots hiding their pet orc here. Tell me about yourself. Sorry. Thought you were a zombie. Never can be sure about these days. Tell me about Cecile. Now, that's a sad story. Whose elephant homes burned for fuel? Oaken cupboards emptied, and ladies dragging the drags of their great skirts to bargain for fish bones. Dregs. My bad. Do you know about the undead plague? See, the name people probably have more information. The people that are just called citizens, I wouldn't bother. Probably. They probably don't have much to say. Praise be to Aru, the wizard, and the wits about him to build those newfangled weapons of his. Of course, the steel would have been the very throne of decay by now. Because of him, life here is almost bearable despite the Walking Dead. Though it's rather eerie and perplexing at the same time to think about how quickly one adjusts to great dangers when a handful of guardians hold them at bay. Tell me about the attack upon the harbor. Many of us nearly lost our own lives in that debacle. It was all hands on deck, and anybody who could wield a pitchfork was armed and ready to hold the line. Tell me about the Legion. If you get bored, you can always engage a Legionnaire in some conversation. They're happy to tell you all about their feats of valor and skills between belches. Can you tell me about the orcs? Suppose the ones attacking us are as brutal as any soldiers are given to be, but it's widely known that orcish society isn't totally unlike... Okay, I think I heard this one before. So what's the latest gossip? As far as I'm concerned, Aru's wasting time with those skeletons in the moor. The orcs are the real threat. Those who just don't know what to care. Uncle, at this rate, we'll be facing a trickle of bloodthirsty sororities for the rest of our days. Just murder indeed at the port off itself and catching his wife in his bed with a barrel. Okay.
Bye.
Yeah, some of that was repeat. Charmed She-Orc. Okay.
Greetings.
Marius. Who better than the proven orc crusher to convince my dumbbell of a friend that orcs are predators, not pets? Ninius. Enough of that. I know how dangerous an orc can be. This one has been reformed. Anyone can see that she's completely docile. But my prejudiced friend here still wants to kill her. Tell me about yourselves. Maybe before the Great Orc Raid, we had time to indulge in any idiotic obsessions. But now we're needed in our posts. I can hardly believe I've been wasting time protecting an orc when I should be running them through. Excuse me, my friend's violent outburst. He hasn't enjoyed a woman's touch in quite some time now. Makes him a bit edgy. Your woman's touch is less of a loving caress and more of a claw shank brutally through the throat. I'll take my chances as a bachelor, thanks. He's referring to the orc. What's this about a charmed orc? My friend here and I were patrolling outside the city walls, and who did I see creeping along the shores but this lovely orcish lady? For a brief second, as long as eternity, we locked eyes. Perhaps, confused by the butterflies in her stomach, she sprang up and began running, claws bared, towards Marius. Fortunately for him, I had the presence of mind to ignore my sword and instead adroitly fling my pouch of trinkets toward her. A vial of potion shattered over her head, and when she turned to face me, she became instantly enamored. You had a love potion? Just on you. While you were patrolling. Why? Was it for this exact instance? I'm sure she must have been compelled to join the orcish army under some kind of duress. A lady with such a sweetly savage manner would never willingly join up with those vicious marauders. I can assure you there wasn't a hint of sweetness in those murderous eyes when she lunged at my throat. She may be confined here for now, but who's telling when she'll escape and who she'll rip to shreds? A love potion, tell me more. I always had an amateur interest in all things alchemical. Okay, this is what I wanted to know. When I read in an esteemed periodical from Wizards of Youthful Gore, about an amazing opportunity that could change my life. I had to act fast, or lose a once-in-a-lifetime deal. So you bought into a ad. It was an infomercial. Love potions. It might save your life from a female savage orc. Buy it now. Just $9.99. That's right, 999 gold pieces. I sent away for the world's famous love potion, available for a limited time only, and it was worked exactly as promised. It's available for a limited time only until the day you die. Did we see what a fool my friend has been, spending all his cash on snake oil and bringing a temporarily tranquilized monster into our midst to boot? What kind of monster would lie in a published advertisement? What kind of monster would lie in a published advertisement? I'm sure the effect of the potion will be everlasting, as printed. Let me tell you what I think. They both have something to say. Marius, you see? He believed it was noon at midnight if you read it on a printed pamphlet. Please tell me you can reason with him. Or just reason and use your sword to save him from the murderous darling. Let her live. That potion were truly worthless. It wouldn't have been able to charm her in the first place. In this docile state, she may prove to be a source of valuable information. See, I could still see Lydia thinking that the information is more useful than the risk, all things considered. So you're right, the information she brought could tell turn the tides here and to see you. Bravo, I trust not only the potion, but the scaly square in it herself. You're going to regret this. We're all going to regret this.
Bye.
I really hope that there's a follow-up on this. I want to see more of that. Oh, wait.
Too bitting, indeed. Not even a skeptic like you can deny that she loves
an orc in love? When this little charm fades, she'll liberate the flesh from our faces.
Good on you. These buff.
Back again.
And a shovel and gold. Okay.
Bye.
I'm not about to blatantly just wander into something I shouldn't.
And then I said to him, I said myself, if I don't start earning an extra gold piece an hour, I'll walk out that door. Good on you. These boss men respect confidence, you know. So what
okay,
do they
this
say
is the town.
Day labor's more suited to my nature.
Huh. Yes. I like how this map actually functions. It's very pretty design. Did I miss something down here? I might have to go back. That entrance.
And then I said to him, I said myself, if I don't start earning an extra gold piece an hour.
Yes, I'm sure of it. Tell it to mind its own business.
Oh, there's that famous Scorpius temper of yours.
Fish rack. There's definitely fish there. We'll take a fishing rod, seriously. Food-ish items. Alrighty.
Greetings.
Hey, halt. These gates remain closed at all times. Captain's orders. Wait a second. Well, I'll be a little Red Jim's uncle. Source Hunters. Sorry for the gruff treatment. I didn't recognize you right away. Teach me how I can aid in the investigation. So civilians aren't allowed outside this gate? You can see security is tighter than ever around here since the surprise attack the orcs put on a fortnight ago. They certainly did enough damage to shake up Aru and Captain Arius something fierce. You can only hope to hold back the undead in these left. Orc attack long enough for the reinforcements to arrive. Take my leave. I'm not going to open the gate yet. I have other stuff to look at here.
I can't even smell the sea air over this rot.
Fuck the orc.
Greetings.
Oh yeah, nothing.
Bye.
Nothing of interest. Hill. You asked me the council would do well to evacuate the rest of the people here and give them the city to the lost. Well, everyone in those rotten carcasses to me. They're the reason we've been stuck in this dead-end town for nay of 2 bloody years. Nigh. It's nigh, isn't it? All fun games in the beginning, but just you lose a couple friends fighting them fiends, get used to lousy rations, and have a bit of drink and dice for entertainment. You'll soon come to realize there are hundreds of cohorts the world around. You're drew to the short straw. With the Legion. You know what I like most about the Legion? Once you're sworn in, you're everybody's equal. You might as well set two legionnaires stand guard, one of them born in a pigsty, the other on a duchess bed, and doesn't matter none. Tell me about the orcs. One morning, 2 weeks ago, I startled awake the sound of shrill trumpet screeches. Each legion stomach flashed icy cold in its gut. There were breaches in the borders. In a frenzy, we were flung to our feet in our boots, hitched our scabbards, and ran to the harbor. The orcs were already waiting. We fought like hell and lost many good men. But Aru's intervention, Cecile would have been lost that day.
Bye. See you. Greetings.
Bye. Yeah, a lot of repeat.
Greetings.
Bye. Yeah, it's a lot of repeat information. Clearly interesting music here. I'm not sure what the purpose. Let's make sure this sheet doesn't get out. I didn't do that! Music.
So ardently did he crave creamy blues and gory reds that he ordered a contest across his room. Today, a king, the great Sigurd and his rainbow of war machines. It is said, and this I have heard, goes to you. Who knew Elliot? Who is safe?
Anybody? Neither of you cares to plead for his very existence? So, which of you is more deserving of life?
Grace.
I overheard that. I don't like what's going on there. I have to go and check this out.
Oh, that tome on soothing a corpse's
Anybody?
Troubled mind.
Neither of you cares to plead for his very existence.
I mean, this is a private sick room. In the name of the seventh. Then do you think you are barging in here? How did I say? Right this instant. Tell me about yourself. I'm sorry. It's this task. I feel my very being unraveling at the most tenuous seams. I am an apprentice for healing arts. Healing. But the decision feels like precisely the opposite. I have but one healing stone, see, and two direly wooden men who need it. I've been tracking my brain trying to figure out figure the best method to settle this grave situation. Perhaps it's better off in the hands of esteemed source hunters. Certainly you are more accustomed to weighing life and death than I am. Your healing stone. That's a curious relic indeed. I got it from a kindly abbot, Loic by name. The northern town of Silverglen. He is a certain faith. The Immaculates. They call themselves espouse the belief that certain stones can heal wounded flesh. I myself was nothing if not skeptical of this claim, but something happened and he handed me the stone. A small cut in my finger instantly healed, leaving no trace of the wound. Needless to say, I was astounded. But it's strange. The stone was only good for a single use at a time before it reverts to a useless inert state. It takes time to regain its magical properties, and I guard it cautiously. Tell me more about the patients. What would you like to know? I'd like to know about Boris. One of the brave few willing to traverse the trade routes plagued by the undead. A young man, but excellent in matters of business. Before he fell victim to an orcish club in the north, that is. Thankfully for him, a cattle raider found him nearly dead, but not quite so, and brought him here to straight away. I'd like to know about Stephen. Quite the venerable staple of Cecile. Stephen, and recently blessed with his third grandchild, he was leading a crew of builders when a stray beam struck him in the temple. Only a few days shy of his last day of work before retirement, no less. Of course. 2 days from retirement! Nearly everyone to see the familiar getting Stephen. As you can imagine, he's quite dear to the fans, his family. Ready to make my decision, are you? Thank you, Militants, for your help. You decide should receive the healing stone. War's life has just begun. We can't cut his life short now. You should receive the stone. There's no way Boris should receive this stone, oh, Steve. I think of the white child of the grandchildren. Steve is an old man. He's lived a long, full life. Boris should have the same chance. His death will hurt far more lives than Boris will. Let's him minimize the heartbreak and several issues and save Steve. Oh my gosh! Come down to this one roll. Oh! Gideon won! No, we'll do as I say. Of course it is. I'll just deliver the stone. I will have to save one man, but my heart breaks for the other.
No, this is highly abnormal. What is this lightning?
Sorry, friend, I was covering the stones for
the heck did I just do? Did I just kill myself?
What?
I don't know.
You're talking to me? Well, hello there.
Zigzags. By the quill of the last civilian words, what's this? What are you doing here? Where did the fairy stars come to die? Freeman, where have you come from? Where are your sorcerers from the realm of Rivellan? Are you indeed? Let me tell you, hunters of the source? You have strayed far, far from home, far in space and far in time. How, I wonder? All you is approach a strange stone, a stone with blinding light that whirled us away. A stone, you say? Could it be? Could it have been right all along? A stone! What was it? Was it bright and beauteous as a diamond? But did it glow softly deep down in its heart, as if its soul dwelled within? I'd say that's a fairly accurate description. Let's see what the trade. No! I'd say that's a fairly accurate description. Starstone! It must be. For centuries I slept. This bounty of the heavens. How it is waking and it is awakened. But now it is waking and it has brought its awakeners here. But all was dark and all was still, as it always has been and always would be. Or so I thought. So I feared. But then the ruins all around me began to shiver, shine, and dance, like fair-winged fairies roused from slumber. Starstone, could it be the key after all? And you, its wielder, things of light, no. Light to unlock things of darkness, lead us into the realms forbidden, where salvation may yet be found. It'd be great if you started making sense right about now. Oh, I have been making sense all along, my friend, though I didn't even see it. See, that is what you must do. Approach the looking lens and hold it, if you dare. The darkness before which even the cosmic shadows flee in terror.
You know, I think that imp may be quite mad.
Then we better appease him and have a look through the looking lens.
In a second. Ooh, pretty. Even though all the stones look exactly the same. Portal has become active. Let's hope that this takes me home.
Oh, what strange new world is this?
Where on the world are we?
We are not on the world at all.
Jeez. This is like a... kind of a hub. I tried every imaginable tongue, from dwarf lineage to lizardese, but these women simply won't budge. Maybe she just doesn't like the look of a refined, impish face like mine. Perhaps you'll have a better luck. But do please report back to what you find, Source Hunter.
So long!
Last chest. I have the last chest. The last chest. The last chest. If you believe yourself worthy of going through my handful of treasures, do dare to prove it. Find my four sisters, no more than one in each of the four realms of your wide, wide world, and each of you will discover how to open me. Oh! Jesus!
Well, hello there.
So much to see, so much to discover, and not a little time to do this. I'm not a child. Dark does not scare me. How brave you are. How bold and hardy. Too bad it won't help you even a little bit when you seemingly inevitable end comes to swallow you whole. This maw of darkness, it consumes time itself. Yeah, Starstone Starter, you have just witnessed the end of all, the maelstrom that, like a carrion eater devouring targets of creation. Space and time have lost all meaning. They are falling prey to the void, and in the void, there is no existence. A bleak prospect indeed, but yet I do not seem to despair. I did despair, for the longest of times I did, aeons upon aeons, as I have traveled through the reaches of time. The rifts that lead to the worlds unimaginable, hoping to find something, anything that could put a stop to the maelstrom. That is how I found this place, and I knew that it would be here, but the answer must be hidden. Seems that a mystery undiscovered, the power that is limitless, yet out of reach, until you came along, the ones who can say, tame Starstone. I think I've started a completely different storyline. Am I in a different game? You have drowned my despair. You, whom I believe can end the time, end the end of time. I think it's time you tell me who you are, Sir Imp. But of course, I am Zigzax, the Imp Historian, tasked by the gods to write the history of all creation. Faithfully, I have fulfilled my task and would have done so perpetually until one day I saw a time will end. Impossible, I thought. Inconceivable. I do not think you know what that word. I don't think that word means what you think it means. For the gods have told me that their work was infinite, both in date and in distance. For my eye did not deceive me when the maelstrom I beheld. Time would end. I would end. All would end. No, I cried. Never. She'll save time if it's the last thing I do. So far my efforts have been in vain. But you, as the saying goes, are the hope that springs eternal. We are the chosen ones! Starstone's the end of time? A source hunters. How about you connect the dots for me?